in the world of fragrance, making you smell delicious and offending you at the same time may be considered especially heinous. In New York City, a gorgeous Cubano and his elite squad of ball sprayers will seek out these colognes and investigate them. This is his story, bitch.
I can't front, wifey tore it down on yesterday's video, and I appreciate you guys showing her mad love, being respectful, and encouraging her to come back on camera and do a video with me. Who else wouldn't want to do it with such a gorgeous woman like my wife? I am blessed. But now she's forced to do it because you gave her the 1,000 likes she asked for, so...
got it!
But I can't front. Doing the video with her yesterday kind of brought something to mind. I'm like, damn, I've had Caban a little bit over a week and change. And I've already gotten these kind of reactions, including from her, so... starting to make me wonder, is Caban better than Tuxedo? Let's roll my motherfucking music and have this discussion real quick, because I'm feeling kind of confused. We're all alone. Blessed morning, my beautiful peoples. You know who it is. This is your boy, C to the U to the B to the A. I ain't gonna lie, this is my boo. YSL Tuxedo is my shit. That's my boo. This is my first love. This has done everything for me that you can think of. We have some amazing memories together. Clearly, she gets more work than everybody else. But Caban came in smacking motherfuckers like, yo, brah! And then wifey, upon first sniff, loved it. She fucks with Tuxedo. But the reaction that she gave for Caban is nowhere near the one that Tuxedo had. So I'm like, is Caban really better than Tuxedo? I don't know, I'm feeling some type of way because they're really different. Tuxedo is spicy, delicious, sexy, grown man, patchouli. It has all the sex appeal that you will want from a fragrance, from a man's perspective. Now from my wife's perspective, who is by far Guinness Book of World Records, page 838, pickiest chick on the face of the fucking planet when it comes to fragrance, Caban, which is something that's peppery, tonka, and rose-ish, is like through the charts. She loves this shit. Now I'm not gonna lie, when I got Caban, all first smell was like, wow, this is super nice, sensual, slightly seductive. It's not overly masculine. I know my wife felt that it was something that it was a very masculine smell. For me, I think it's super unisex, definitely leans more masculine. But I think this is something very versatile, especially with the sweet rose that's in here. But it's not a dirty rose, it's not old. There's no dirtiness here, it's just soft, sensual, seductive, up close. It has a sexy vibe about it that really got me fucked up. Now when I smell Tuxedo, I get sweet, sexy, a little bit of a cola vibe, tobacco-y, just grown man shit. This, I get like the split personality of that. I get the softer, more sensual. Let's sit down, have a conversation while I put a finger in your ass. Like, we have that kind of outlook on Caban. I absolutely got instant compliments on Tuxedo, but I absolutely got instant compliments on Caban. Faster than Tuxedo. I can't front. The rose in here, it not being so OD prominent, or maybe not as realistic as some other roses, just hits all the sexy marks that I want. So to be honest with you, right now, Caban is fucking the game up. It came out with authority. It came out sexy. It came out standing its ground. It came out blowing my wife's nasal receptors out. Like, she thought this was sexy as fuck next to Chergy, which is her absolute favorite when it comes to dark and spicy. So Caban might be getting more wears than Tuxedo right now because I want to see what other people really react to this joint. I sampled Caban at the store before I even made this purchase, but I'm going to have to get more of this line because honestly, these aren't the only two that have been popping from this line. I want to get Kaftan, I want to get Vinyl, I want to get a bunch of the other ones from these lines because the shit is popping. Which other ones do y'all recommend from this line of YSL Private Blend or Le Viste, whatever the fuck brand, do y'all recommend? Because honestly, this is amazing. These two are breathtaking. These two are amazing. These two are sexy. These two are powerful. These two are not cheap. So you definitely have to shop them. If you can get them pre-owned, get them pre-owned. With Tuxedo, at least we got the dual clone, which smells fucking 96% close. Caban, we don't have a clone for this. I don't know if they're gonna develop a clone because it doesn't have a hype yet. But honestly, Caban is gonna be the ball sprayer today. That you can't even be mad at this shit. Caban is gorgeous. I love y'all motherfuckers from the heart. Check out these fragrances because this YSL line holds a special place to my heart. And I'll see y'all bitches next time. You know who it is? It's the biggest in the fucking game. Smooches. Hello, hello, hello.
For the fly gun holder, money folder, Motorola, star tag, when it's time to call back. For the rough, rugged, and raw way, this nigga Jay, it's a game, but he don't play. For all the chicks that got dead in the penthouse suite on top of my mom's crib. It's nonsense you never get in. It's nonsense that you would think that you would.